Hello, my amazing subscribers and welcome newcomers. I am Carnage the Creator and welcome back to a brand new episode of Survival Adventures in the wonderful world of Carnage. That's right, we're back again in the world of Carnage. And man, oh man, why hungry. I just noticed my hunger bar is way down, but we're going to go ahead and eat up some steaks really quick. And then what we're going to do at some point in this episode, we're going to get started on that barn again. But before we get started on the barn again, cows down there. Hey, I got a bone to pick with you guys because I only need to kill a few more of you to finally finish up my awesomely cool library. We only need 3 more books of knowledge to get this thing going down. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and run on down here. We're going to kill up a bunch of cows and we're going to, make ourselves a bunch of books. So we're going to get about 9 leather. I'm hoping I can get exactly 9 leather. We might end up with a little bit more, but let's try to get exactly 9 leather. So we've got 3, 5. Some of these drop a little bit more than 1, 6, 7, 8. And do we get another one? Hold up, let's see if we get one more. Can we get the perfect number? Oh no, we got it. We got it. Yeah, we got exactly 9. Let's go ahead and get on out of here. Get out of here, cows. Unless you want to get, do you want to get hurt? You better back up, cows. I'll slice you up and I'll eat your steaks. Don't you mess with me. I know how you guys think. I know you're trying to mob up on me, but we're going to go ahead and run on out here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to make ourselves a bunch more oak because we need it. We need it to make ourselves some books. So we're going to go right on over here. Make ourselves some, a bunch of books. We're going to make ourselves 9. Oh, wait, 10 books. Oh, we already had a book, didn't we? Oh, whatever. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and make ourselves 3 bookshelves really quick. And then we can run on up here and we can put our knowledge where our brain noodles are. Wait, what are we talking about? We're going to go ahead and go right on up here and we're going to put our knowledge in our knowledge bank, aka the library of awesomeness, hashtag awesome library. So, with that said, I think we can do it at this point. I mean, we don't really need this book right now. So what we can do is we can go put this book up. And while we're down here, we can also put up some other stuff that we don't need. So we're going to go ahead and put this book in here along with this flint that we don't need. Wait, do we need this flint? No, we don't because we've got 28 arrows. You know what? Yeah, we're not gonna need that. We'll make some more arrows later on. Because we'll need ourselves some flint and some sticks and whatever else and a feather. So let's go ahead and also put up our gunpowder and we'll put up. I think that's it. I think that's good. So we're gonna go ahead and cook up these steaks really quick and then we're gonna go get started on that barn. And that barn has just got to get started, man. We gotta get it going. We're not gonna take forever. Oh, I almost put paper in there. You don't want to put paper in your furnace. Definitely don't want to do that. So we're gonna go ahead and grab these steaks out of here. And we're going to put up 30 of them real quick. And then I think for today, let's do that. Let's combine our carrots. We have all of our carrots right here. We got tons of steak. I kind of wanted to grab a different source of meat for today, but we really don't have that much. Look at that. That's all we have. We've got 8 cooked chicken. We've got 2. We got 2 rabbits and we've got 1 mutton. We really are. Oh no, we've got 10 cooked mutton. You know what? Let's hang on to that then. We'll hang on to the muttons. We'll put the muttons go in our belly button. So let's go right on over here. And we're going to get started again on this barn. And then I got another little project that I would like to do that I've been thinking about doing here for a while. And Bandit, what are you doing over here, man? I forgot I was having you guard the barn. And it looks like it might start getting nighttime sometime soon. So you can continue your job of guarding the barn right on over here. We're going to let you hang out right there. And what we're going to do now is we're going to get this top outline done of the barn. So we'll go ahead and place our wood right on over here. Just like so, all the way across like this. And we're going to do the same thing for this section as well. So we're going to go ahead and run this all the way over here. Now we had 16 logs. So we should... Oh no, I placed that in the wrong spot. We should be able to finish these 2 sections right here. But we're not going to have enough logs to get the rest of it done. So we are most definitely going to need to get ourselves some more logs. So I think what we should do right now, before it gets dark, let's go do what we did in the last episode. Let's go make ourselves a bunch of trees. And you can see some of them are still actually over there. But we're going to go ahead and make ourselves a bunch of trees all in this giant field. And then we're going to chop them all down. So let's grab ourselves our awesomely cool saplings and our bone meal. We really don't have much of, but we do have, oh yeah, we do. We have bones. Let's go over to this crafting table. We're going to make ourselves some more bone meal. And then, and only then will we do what needs to be done and place these trees. So let's go ahead and go into our crafting table. We'll make ourselves some awesome cool bone meal. As much of it as we possibly can. Well, actually, we should have more than a stack. So let's not... Oh, we went over the stack. I was going to say, let's not go over a stack, but we just did it anyway. So let's go. run right on over here. And man, we still got a lot of terraforming to do. We got to terraform like the backside over here where this pumpkin farm is. And we also got to do this terraforming area right here. We kind of been neglecting doing that, but we'll get that done eventually. Let's go ahead and start planting ourselves some saplings. We'll place one sapling right here. We'll go ahead and start growing this one right here. We'll go ahead and do another one a little bit of ways away right here. Go ahead and do some more of that stuff right there. Go ahead and place another one right here. Oh, no, not right there. Let's do it right here. And then go ahead and place some more bone meal like this. There we go. Got to get a little bit further away. We do have saplings still dropping from the trees from last episode. So we'll go ahead and... Oh, I accidentally made the grass grow. Didn't mean to do that. Tree, what are you doing? You're supposed to be growing, man. You're using way too much bone meal. There you go, tree. Alrighty. So we're going to go ahead and grab some more saplings over here. Plant this one. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. That's not what I meant to do. We'll plant another one right there. We're going to let this thing grow right here. Actually, let's get it a little bit away from the sunflower. We'll go ahead and place it right here. And now we'll make it grow. And we'll go ahead and place another one right here. We've got to make this grow really quick. Gonna go ahead and place another one here. We're basically gonna go until we run out of bone meal. So we're gonna go ahead and place this one right here. Go ahead and place this one right here. We're just gonna have a giant field of oak trees, and we'll come back over here in just a little bit and we'll chop them all down. So we'll go ahead and place another one right here. We're not gonna chop them down in the middle of the night. That'd be crazy talk. So let's go ahead and do this one right here. It looks like we have enough bone meal for one, maybe two more trees. So we'll place this one right here. Gonna grow that one up really quick. We'll do one more right here, and hopefully we have enough. No, that's not going to be enough. We'll go ahead and bring this sapling with us. So, we have ourselves a giant line of trees, but before we go ahead and start chopping them down and stuff like that, we're going to go to sleep, and once we wake up, we're going to come right back over here and start chopping all these trees down and stuff like that. So, we're going to go ahead and run right on over here. And also, we're not just going to do the outline of the barn today. I'm thinking we could use some more of the red and white wool, and we could at least get one side of the barn done today. I'm hoping we can at least get one side done today. As far as filling it in and everything like that. So we're gonna go ahead and run right on over here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to close this door and we're gonna go to sleep. Bandit should be over there by the barn guarding stuff, making sure that nothing goes near our construction site. And we're gonna go ahead and go to sleep really quick. And once we wake up, we should be ready to go. We've got an axe that's just about had it. We need to go check and see how many diamonds we have. We really don't have enough diamonds to do everything that we need to do. So we're gonna have to go down the mineshaft in a little bit. But let's go ahead and check and see. We've got three. That's like just enough. So let's see if that's what we're gonna have. I think that's gonna we're gonna have to. Yeah, it's gonna take three. So you know what? Let's go with an iron. I don't know. I don't want to use the last three diamonds. So I think we're going to have to go with an iron axe whenever it comes down to us. Let's go ahead and put those up for now because I'd rather have a diamond pickaxe, and this one's just about had it. So we're going to have a new diamond pickaxe, and then we're going to have to make ourselves an iron axe. I think that's what we're going to have to do. But let's go ahead and run right on over here. I'm not going to mess around with that spider. That spider's not bothering me right now, so we're going to go ahead and leave it on over there. And what we're going to do now is we're going to go chop down all these trees that we just planted. Also, we most definitely need to put some of this mutton in our belly button. This is delicious. Eat one more really quick. There we go. All right. So we're going to go ahead and run right on over here. Again, we still have some terraforming to do over here. We have this whole river thing that we're trying to cover up and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and go right here. And let's chop this down. We're going to do one thing at a time. Today, we are most definitely focused on the barn because I want to get these animals out there. Oh! Oh my goodness, I just got blown up by a creeper. That was not cool, creeper. I did not notice you anywhere around at all. Whew, that was scary. So let's go ahead and grab all this dirt really quick. I'm going to leave this hole here for now. I don't want to worry with patching up because I don't think I have enough dirt. So we're going to leave it there for now. Let's hopefully no more creepers are around. Let's hope that doesn't happen again. So let's go right on over here. We're going to chop down every last tree that we planted over here. I think I might have chopped down. Oh no, I can get it. I was gonna say I might have chopped down one too many because I was gonna have to jump up to get that one. But the tree wasn't tall enough, so we're good enough to get that up there. So we're gonna go ahead and get these right here. And this is what I was talking about: chop down the trunk. Sometimes if you have a taller tree, you don't want to chop down the bottom portion of it because you can actually stand on to get up a little bit higher. So we're gonna go ahead and chop these down really quick. We should have only a few more trees to chop down. We've got oh my goodness, we planted a bunch of these. Let's go ahead and keep on going. I was gonna say a few more, but look at this. Look how many we planted. We planted a ton of these, and our axe is definitely going to break at some point in time, probably before this episode is over. So let's go ahead and I was gonna say it's definitely gonna break, but we don't know. You know, sometimes with diamond tools they last a little bit longer than you would think they would. So we're gonna go ahead and continue chopping on through here. And it looks like we're just about, oh, look at the axe. The axe has just about had it. We are down to nothing. We are literally chopping with nothing right now. We've got the bare essentials of an axe right now. Hopefully we can get through this last tree. It's really all I'm hoping for is to get through this last little tree right here. There we go. We got through this last tree. And let's look around. Let's make sure. Oh my goodness. Hold up. There's actually an entire oak forest over here. Look at this. I knew it was here, but I totally have been like forgetting that it was here. Let's chop down one more tree really quick, and we're gonna see if this axe will break from one more tree. Let's see about this. We're gonna try to get a full stack. We got 58. You know what? Let's actually go for another tree because we can get a little bit more and get that full stack going on. We got 63. You know what? Let's go with a little bit over a stack because I said we're gonna get a full stack, so we're gonna get one. So there we have over a full stack. There we go. Let's go ahead and move on. Our axe is not actually broke yet. We're so close to breaking it. So you know what? Let's just break a few more in here. Let's just see if we can get this axe to break today. So we're gonna go ahead and keep on chopping on through here. We're not going to chop down every tree in a row. We're going to try to spread it out. So it still looks like an oak forest over here. We're going to try to just chop down a little here, a little there. So we're going to go right on through here. We'll chop down this one right here. We'll get all this wood right here. And this axe is not breaking. This is what I'm talking about. The axe does not break exactly when you think it's going to break. You never really know. Oh, there it goes. And we're going to get the rest of these with our hand really quick. It should not take much time at all. And we have over a stack of wood. This is definitely going to go far as building. So we're going to go ahead and get this right here. And I don't want to completely get rid of this forest. You definitely don't want to get rid of all of your forest because then you'll just have a bare world. So we're going to make sure that we just take some of the trees out of this forest. And we're going to mainly be getting trees by planting them on our own. Wait, did we plant this one right here? This one wasn't here before, was it? You know what? We're going to go ahead and chop this one down as well with our hand, just because it's in the middle of the field, and we don't really want that to be there. So we're going to go ahead and chop this one down really quick. And then when we're back by our house, we can make ourselves a new axe. So let's go ahead and get the last little bit of this wood really quick. We'll get the outline of it done, of the main part of the house, and then, or not the main part of the house, the main part of the barn, and then we could get probably one portion of the wall done. Hopefully, we can hopefully get a portion of the wall done. So we're gonna go ahead and put these saplings up really quick. We're gonna grab this other stack of oak really quick as well, and then we're going to run, and on our way back over here, we're most definitely going to consume one more cooked mutton. We're gonna put the mutton in our belly button. We got half a hunger bar left. Oh no, it went up, look at that. It went up all the way. I didn't think it was going to go up, but it actually did. So we're going to go ahead and go right on over here. And then we're going to place these where they need to be. So we need pretty much 8 per section. So this is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then this section right here is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because it's the back section. And this middle section right here should be 8 again. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then this section should be 5 again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then this, all of these sections should be 8. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, hold up. I'm not close enough. 5, 6, 7, and 8. And here we go. 1, 2. Oh my goodness. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And here we go. The final 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And look at that. We've got all of the outline done of the bottom part of the barn. Now, we are going to have a giant roof on this thing. So, we're definitely not anywhere close to being done with this thing at all. But, and we're definitely going to need a lot more wood. But, we can at least get, this side portion done right here. Maybe even a little bit more than that. So, what I want to do is I want to do something along the lines of what we did here. So basically we have ourselves a slanted line. It kind of goes from the top to the bottom. So we're going to try to do the same thing over here. So we're going to go put a block right there. And then what we're going to do is put a block right here. We're going to copy it basically. So we're going to put 2 right there, 2 right there. And I'm thinking, you know what? Let's make it 3. And then what we'll do is we'll go ahead and put this here and this here. So basically we'll get rid of this block right here. We'll also get rid of this block right here, which I should have my shears out. Let's go ahead and grab our shears so we can do this a lot quicker. And then, once we've done that, I'm pretty sure our slant should look good. Yeah, that looks good. And then we could go ahead. See, I want the middle section to be the shorter part because that's exactly how it is here. See, it's 2 and then 1 and then 2. So the middle section is 1 block shorter. And that's the same thing here. So it's 3, then 2, then 3. So I think this is going to work out absolutely perfectly. So we're going to go ahead and place our red wool right here. And then we're going to go ahead and run some more right here. We're going to leave it like that. And then what we're going to do, this middle section right here is made out of cobblestone. So we're going to do the same thing over here in the middle. But let's go ahead and first get this section done over here because we want to mirror what we've done over here. So we're going to put the exact opposite. We're going to put white wool right here. And we're going to go ahead and take this one down with shears. Place three just like that. And then we'll go up two. And then we'll go up one, two, three more like that. We'll go ahead and get rid of these extra pieces right here and right here. And then we could go ahead and run our red wool across like this. And this is basically the same thing that we're going to be doing all throughout the whole entire barn. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side as well. It's basically going to mirror exactly what we've done over here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to grab our cobblestone and we're going to make ourselves a wall right here. So we're going to go ahead and fill this all the way in like this. I'm going to go ahead and triple layer it just like so. And then what we're going to do is get this last little bit right here. But we do want to go back on into the inside because we want to get rid of this block right here. We don't want any extra blocks hanging around if we don't have to. We want to keep it kind of nice and organized and stuff like that. But let's go check this out from the other side. It should look as good as I'm hoping. So we're going to go ahead and go right on over here. And of course, all of these farms over here are definitely going to have to end up getting taken down and stuff like that. Oh goodness, there's a cow over here. And you know what? I don't really need to kill the cow because we've got plenty of beef. And we also have plenty of books because we already finished our library, so we don't really have to do anything else right now. But look at this, we have ourselves a completed side of the barn. We don't have any type of roof going on yet, but we at least got the important stuff done. We got the base part of it done, so we can start actually planning out the inside of this thing. And once we get the inside of this thing planned out, then we can start moving animals in, and then we can work on like the roof and stuff. Or maybe we'll work on the roof first, I don't know, we'll figure out what we're gonna do. But while we're at this, let's go ahead and do three, then two. Hold on, is this right? One. No, that's four. All right, so we're gonna get rid of this one right here, and then we're going to go ahead and place this up here, and get rid of this one right here, and then we're gonna go ahead and put our cobblestone up, grab our red wool, place these two right here, and then use our red wool to run across right here, and this should be the exact same pattern that's on the other side. It should mirror it absolutely perfectly. So it's three, then two, then three. So we got three, two, and three, and we can go ahead and put the rest of this wool right here, and that's looking good. The next thing we're gonna do, oh goodness, we done fell off the side. So we're gonna go ahead and grab ourselves some more cobblestone and fill this side in over here, and then we could do the back side, which is pretty much gonna match the front side, and this whole thing should be done, should be looking good and ready to go. And then once we've done that, we could kind of start planning out the inside, and once we planned out the inside, we could start planning out the roof. So I want to kind of do that simultaneously. I don't want to work on the inside and not the roof, because the roof is definitely going to have like a major part of how the upstairs of this thing is going to look. So basically we have to kind of plan that stuff out at once. It might even be smarter for us to do the roof first. That way we have more of an idea of what we can do on the inside. So with that said, we do have to mirror that side again. The white wool needs to be on this side right here. So we're going to go ahead and put some white wool right here. We're going to chop this down really quick. This is going to go over one, two, three, and then we're gonna go ahead and go, oh wait, that makes it four. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and get rid of this one right here. And then what we're gonna do is place a block here, and then go one, two, three, and then get rid of this block, just like so. We're gonna jump on up here, grab that white wool. We don't wanna have any wool going to waste. And then what we're gonna do is go ahead and fill all of this in. So this is gonna be the exact mirror of what's on the other side. So we're gonna double check this here in just a second, just to be sure. But let's go ahead and get the red wool on here. We're gonna go ahead and put this right here. Put the red wool right here as well. And just like that, we have all of that done. That's gonna be the exact mirror of this side, which means all that is left to do, and you know what, we actually almost just about have enough time to do this, but I think we should finish this up in the last episode. But all we have left to do is this little section right here, which is gonna mirror the front over there, and then this cobblestone right here, and then we could literally just start working on the inside and the roof and stuff like that. So we are getting a lot of this done. But for now, let's go ahead and go to sleep really quick, and then we're gonna go to the Wall of Carnage. We got so much work done today. We've got our bookshelves completely finished in our library, and we've got our barn like actually legitimately getting put up today. We've got a lot of stuff going on today, and we're very close to being able to move some of these animals in, and I cannot wait to actually get that done. And then we can move on to other projects other than the barn. We can move on to other big projects and get all kinds of cool stuff built. So we're gonna go ahead and run right on over here. We're gonna take a look at it really quick, and then we're gonna go over to the Wall of Carnage. Man, look at that. That's gonna be awesome. Our barn is looking nice, it's looking colorful, it's looking cool, and I'm thinking this world's gonna turn out absolutely awesome over here. So let's go ahead and run right on over here. We're gonna go out the back door, and we're gonna go to the Wall of Carnage and see who has been added today. So, joining us today on the Wall of Carnage is, oh, Oh, there's a zombie over there. Joyously on the Wall of Carnage is Lucas Van. So congratulations, Lucas, on getting added to the Wall of Carnage. Now, remember, guys, if you want to get added to the Wall of Carnage, just like Lucas over here, all you got to do is leave some comments down in the comment section below. Oh, my goodness, there's a zombie code after me. Let's go ahead and kill it really quick. A zombie villager, to be specific. But all you have to do is leave some comments down in the comment section below, and I'll be choosing one lucky person each and every episode to add to the Wall of Carnage. But with that said, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. And if you did, you know what to do. Go ahead and leave a like on this video. And if you are one of the first 100 people to like this video, let me know down in the comment section below. But I've been Carnage the Creator. Catch you guys in the next video. And I'm out. Carnage the Creator. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're watching Carnage the Creator. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're watching Carnage the Creator. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're watching Carnage the Creator. Creator, Creator. Yeah.